A Filipino in Singapore has tested positive for monkeypox. According to Singapore's health ministry, the 31-year-old Filipino male was admitted to the Singapore General Hospital on July 24 and tested positive for the virus a day after. The patient is currently in stable condition. Health authorities in Singapore are still conducting contact tracing to identify and isolate the patient's closest contacts. The Philippine Embassy in Singapore is monitoring the case. The health department, meanwhile, sees no connection between that case and the country's first index case of monkeypox. The World Health Organization recently declared monkeypox a global health emergency. Infectious diseases specialists say chickenpox and COVID-19 or monkeypox and COVID-19 remain more infectious, but people should not be complacent.
Ang kaibahan niyan ay itong chickenpox nga, bulutong tubig, ito yung mabilis makahawa. Mas lubang nakakahawa naman itong chickenpox kumpara po rin sa monkeypox. Kaya nga, ilan-ilan lang yung kaso niyan sa bansang Africa kung saan nag-umpisa yan at kung saan endemic yan.
Without being complacent that you do not get monkeypox by going to the supermarket, it is not as infectious as COVID-19, where the main mode of transmission is aerosol. The main mode of transmission of monkeypox is close intimate contact. Having said that, again, this is still not considered a sexually transmitted disease.
The Philippines logged 4,159 new COVID-19 cases Sunday, the highest daily tally in over 5 months. This brings the number of active infections to more than 33,000. The country's weekly positivity rate also on the rise, but the health department says the country is still considered to be at low risk in terms of average daily attack rate and bed and intensive care unit utilization. It also assures the public it is now strengthening its National Patient Navigation and Reference Center to control the rising number of non-COVID patients in hospitals.
Because we have started parang regular operations already again of our hospitals, then hindi lang po yung COVID cases, no, yung naggagamit ng hospital beds, but more importantly, there are other diseases.
Apart from COVID-19, parts of the Philippines are also grappling with dengue. Cabayan Partylist Representative Ron Sano has expressed alarm over the spike in cases of the mosquito-borne disease and has called for a probe into the government's anti-dengue program. For more on this, we are joined by Congressman Sano himself. Good morning, po, sir. Thank you for joining us.
Good morning, Nikki. Good morning to all our fellow men.
Right. So first off, you're calling for a probe into the National Anti-Dengue Program over a current surge in cases of the mosquito-borne disease. Can you tell us the current measures under the said program and where do you think it falls short?
This is precisely the reason why we're going to ask for an inquiry, Nikki, on the programs being undertaken by the Department of Health, because this is really alarming, the fact that we are having or seeing as 90+% increase from last year's. It means to say that the current programs or activities and the strategies being undertaken by the Department of Health seems to fall short. Perhaps there, as was mentioned a while ago by the Department of Health, perhaps the focus has always been the COVID, addressing COVID-19. Definitely, that's a very good strategy to address COVID-19 in order for us to this particular health threat will be addressed. But of course, this it's equally important that the department would also focus its attention on other diseases such as the dengue.
Following this, can you give us more details into House Resolution number 79, which you filed, seeking to task the House Committee on Health to launch the inquiry? How does it tend to go about the probe? Any updates?
As of the moment, there's none yet, Ms. Nikki, because it has it's yet still to be referred to the committee, appropriate committee, and definitely it's the Committee on Health. And we'll be requesting, of course, we'll be lobbying, quote-unquote, to the Committee on Health to consider it as soon as it is being organized. So the moment, Ms. Nikki, there's yet no Committee on Health chairperson that has been appointed in the House of Representatives. So we're still awaiting who will be heading this particular committee and will be ensuring that this particular resolution that we filed will be considered immediately.
Mm-hmm. And as Sir Ron, you urged the Marcos administration to actually appoint a dengue czar who can give full attention to the problem. How optimistic are you that this issue and your filed bill will be given attention by President Marcos and his administration? Does the lack of a health secretary affect the anti-dengue program?
Well, that's just one of the thoughts that we laid down in this particular, in the press release, not exactly in the House resolution, but I suppose it's very good for the administration also to consider this particular our suggestion, perhaps, or just a thought, in as much as we also have a COVID-19, which we've seen how effective he was in dealing with the, in addressing the COVID effects. So basically, we need someone who would have his full attention, considering that the Department of Health has a gamut, has some various concerns relating to health, and dengue is just one of them. So definitely it will be a good idea if we are going to have a dengue czar who will just focus on this particular issue to make sure that the strategies of the Philippine government will be taken into full consideration, as well as to make sure that all the government, all the persons, stakeholders, will be part of this particular program and strategies being undertaken by the government.
Yeah, Representative Ron, how then do you think the government can focus more on these other pressing diseases like dengue when, as repeatedly mentioned during our discussion, we are still dealing with COVID and now even the entry of monkeypox in the country?
This is the reason why we are suggesting Ms. Tiki to have a person who will focus on this particular issue. In as much as the Department of Health Secretary will be the one to orchestrate the entire efforts of the Philippine government relating to the all the concerns relating to health. But we need someone who will focus on specific areas such as COVID, such as dengue, and perhaps some other communicable or non-communicable diseases that have high impact or are pervasive or very comprehensive in their effects on the Filipino people.
And Sir Ron, you've since also said that it's our children who actually suffer the most, as they are the sector most vulnerable to the threats of dengue, of the dengue outbreak. Can you expound on why this is the case?
I understand, based on the study and the one that was released by the World Health Organization, basically it's really the children who suffers most. And as much as I suppose that the immune system, the children, is not yet well developed compared to the adults. This is the reason why we also need to educate precisely the public, including, of course, the adults and the caregivers, particularly the mothers, to make sure that they will be giving the appropriate care to our children when it comes to addressing dengue.
And as mentioned earlier, dengue cases this year surged 90% from last year. That's almost double, with Antique, which was placed under a state of calamity in mid-July, bearing the brunt. If left as is and not looked into, do you see this trend continuing for many more places in the country?
Yes, Ms. Nikki, unless we're going to do something and consider this as something urgent, I suppose this trend will continue. This is the reason why we filed this particular bill, to immediately arrest this particular continuing increases in COVID cases.
And lastly, you've since said that the current strategies of DOH are not working, as we are again facing the possibility of yet another dengue outbreak throughout the country. What can the local government units then do for their part?
Yes, I suppose the Department of Health could consider ensuring that the strategies being undertaken by the Department of Health will cascade directly to the local health units, particularly those under the local government units. In as much as we have to note also that the LGUs are also at the forefront of this particular addressing any health issues of our country, of the people. We note that the Department of Health is the head, the leader, but we need also the people who are at the forefront of this, particularly the barangay health workers, down to that level. So we hope that the government will, particularly through the Department of Health, will undertake such a comprehensive approach in addressing, in making sure that we immediately address this particular case, sickness or illness, which is dengue.
All right, on that note, we'll continue hoping for the best. Thank you so much for joining us this morning, Representative Ron Sano. Please stay safe.
Thank you, Ms. Nikki.